Would it be inappropriate for me to squeal with delight right now? I'm at Samsung Display, and I cannot wait to show you what's in here. Let's do that again. 3,000 nits, 4,000 nits. Are you starting to understand the big news from Samsung Display this year? Welcome back, everyone. I'm Caleb Dennison at the Samsung Display booth at CES 2025. And if you follow my videos, at least the CES ones, you know this is one of our big stops of the year because Samsung Display is making the displays of the future. These are the displays that go in all of our devices throughout this year and for the years to come. We get a glimpse of the display of the future here. Now, most of you are gonna be interested in how that fits into what's happening with this year's quantum dot OLED TVs. And this is really the big news. At a 3% window, QD OLED can now go up to 4,000 nits. So your peak HDR highlights are gonna have some incredible pop this year. At a, I believe it's 10% window, they can do 2,200 nits, which is extremely impressive. And perhaps most importantly, at full screen white, they can do about 440 nits, which means that in SDR, the TVs are gonna be able to do an incredible job of beating back ambient brightness. That means that QD OLED is an even more marketable display technology in televisions than it was before. But how'd they do it? So the how is actually hidden in this chart here, and it's all about the efficiency of the blue OLED compound. They've actually changed it so it's much more efficient. As the electrons become photons, it's doing it in a much more efficient way. They can use the same amount of power and get a whole lot more brightness out of it. It also, understandably, behaves a little bit different, and I'll explain how that different behavior is an advantage to us in just a minute. But with a much more efficient blue OLED compound, it can now get even brighter without necessarily using more electricity. And of course, the blue OLED is what's setting off the red and green quantum dots, thus enhancing the picture. A lot of folks don't know this, but the quantum dots, the red and green quantum dots, will get as bright as you want them to. They behave in direct reaction to the blue OLED itself. So they don't really have any limitations. The brighter you can get the blue OLED, the brighter the overall picture can become. And here's the proof in the pudding. These are all the new generation QD OLED displays in action. And as you can see, well, hopefully you can see through the camera, through the internet, through your particular display that you're watching it on, these are absolutely brilliant. It looks like this leopard cheetah, somebody tell me what this is in the comments, is leaping off the screen. It's absolutely gorgeous. And indeed, it's all because that new blue OLED compound, more efficient, brighter, and capable of driving the quantum dots to bring you a more true to life picture. Now, this higher efficiency and higher brightness is going into what a lot of people are calling fourth generation QD OLED panels. For them, it's the third iteration. This is the first time they're using this blue OLED material. No matter what you call it, it's the next generation in QD OLED panels and what we're going to be seeing in our TVs in 2025. That means that we can expect Samsung's best TV displays to be using this technology soon. But it's not just about higher brightness and higher efficiency. They've actually increased the pixel density printing process. And how that benefits you is what I want to show you next. And here is the real world application of that kind of super dense printing process. They can now make a full 4K UHD 27-inch QD OLED monitor. So you're gonna get super, super fine resolution, tons of detail all in a compact 27-inch monitor. Now, this is one that at first I was like, really? What practical application does this have? This is a stretchable micro LED display. And by stretchable, I don't just mean you pull it apart. In this demonstration, as the shark gets closer to you, the display actually bulges out. You can feel the display coming out. Now, what kind of practical application might that have? Well, imagine if this was a display in your vehicle and you needed some sort of tactile feedback to know that you're pressing the right button. This could do that for you. But also it's just kind of fun and interesting to see because if you look at it off to the side, you can actually see the display bulging out and coming back in. We see this kind of thing all the time at CES, where just because you can doesn't mean that you should, but I actually think they might make something practical out of it. See, this is a perfect example of what I'm talking about. I think everybody at some point has put on a pair of sunglasses, likely polarized lenses, and then not been able to see their phone very well, or any number of different screens. Sometimes it blocks out the screen in your car. What Samsung is doing here is removing the polarizing layer from the display itself so that when you put on your sunglasses, it doesn't block out the screen. Any happy face you see here does not have a polarizer. The sad faces do, and what you can see is as we change the polarization lens, we lose the display from some of them, but the rest of them stay bright. This is exactly the kind of thing that we need to make our displays more usable in everyday life. So that was a ton of fun. And now we kind of understand how it is that Samsung Electronics and LG Electronics are going to battle with their OLED TVs this year. First, we hear that LG drops MLA in favor of a different kind of brighter display technology that's supposed to get up into like the 3700 nit zone. Now we have Samsung Display showing 4000 nit quantum dot OLED TVs. Now we understand where OLED is going in 2025, and I could not be more excited.